I'm holding. Yes, the recording has been started. So the next small section or small topic from this analog and digital device application, paper number two, audio amplifier. So basically, everyone knows what is audio amplifier. As you are using mobile phone, you are talking on the phone, you have earphones. Earphones has a system that is converting your acoustic signal, or we can say the vibrations of your from that is coming from your mouth, that is sensed by this particular what we call it as a microphone, or we can say a microphone, and that convert all our acoustic pressure, or we can say the sound signal, into an electrical signal, or we can say there are capacitor, condenser mic is there, there's that microphone where the parallel plate capacitor is there, the change in the pressure, or we can say acoustic pressure or air, it is converted into electrical signal by varying the capacitance of that particular microphone, and this electrical signal goes towards the next section, and that next section is called as audio amplifier. So that will take the electrical signal, a small electrical signal, and convert them into again in audio. So how it is to be done? It is to be done by using an audio amplifier. So this is the basic circuit that is required to amplify the audio signal received from a device like microphone or audio signal. If we need to transmit it through the speaker, through radio devices, through wireless transmitters towards the other people or towards the destination, we require an audio amplifier. So this audio amplifier is used in many applications, from radio wave transmitter to the hi-fi devices. Hi-fi devices mean high fidelity devices, home audio systems, talking toys, robots, even in military applications where we need as an acoustic weapon. So basically what we have, an power amplifier that is designed to take input as the low strength audio signal and generate the output signal that consists of high strength value. So low strength value to the high strength value, this is called as a power amplifier. This process of amplification is utilized in various domains where an electrical signal is converted to an acoustic signal. This type of amplifier is known as audio amplifier. So what we need to convert electrical signal that I have said to you that I am speaking, I am generating the sound signal. That sound signal is sensed by the microphone. It goes towards the amplifier. That amplifier triggers the electrical signal. And if we need to produce the sound, then we can say it as an audio amplifier. So if we are converting them into again electrical form, it will become a power amplifier. So in any circuit which possesses the audio signal as the audio amplifier, both at the input and also at the output, like I am speaking in a mic, and again there is a speaker that gives output to the audience, that become an example where the audio signal is input and the audio signal is again output. If a microphone receives a sound wave input signal, it need to be a pre-amplifier before processing it to a further, the similar before sending an electrical signal to a speaker. So it needs to be pre-amplifier, then again amplifier, and so on. So the circuit of an audio amplifier consists of a transistor, a simple transistor in a common emitter mode. It will help us to build an audio amplifier. So it will apply the input signal and it will give the output signal to the speaker. So the transistor that is connected based on the necessity, but we required in case of audio amplifier. The important factor that needs to be considered while designing an audio amplifier is again, how much the power, or we can say how much it should be multiplied or amplified. It's again noise, if you have to reduce the noise of the environment, the frequency response, means I am speaking, I am a human having an audio frequency from 2 kilohertz to 20 kilohertz. So in between them is needed, or we have to amplify the other signals, and the distortion. Distortion means a disturbances. So higher the gain, higher will be the distortion, higher will be the noise. And however, a negative feedback would reduce the gain of the amplifier. So we should go for the negative feedback. It will reduce the gain of the amplifier. So these are the important factor when we design an audio amplifier. The designing thing is not in your syllabus. The syllabus tells us that you should know the audio amplifier. So that's why we are not going in detail with the designing things. We are going to give only the glimpses of audio amplifier, which components are available and what is the working of that each component. So you can see this is a basic audio amplifier using a transistor. So you can see here the transistor has a base where the signal, the audio signal, is connected to the base of the transistor, where the Cin is the capacitor, input capacitor. The R1 and R2 connected over here, the current I1 is flowing through them. These are the biasing circuits to this particular transistor. The RE is there, emitter resistor. CE, the emitter capacitor, is there. RC, collector resistor, it is having very large quantity or large value. CC, this is a coupling capacitor to the next stage. This is a single stage. If we need multiply the gain, we can have a multiple stages. So where the coupling capacitor will play an important role to connect this particular amplifier to the next stage. And the RL, where the output is measured across this load resistance RL. So basically, this is the single stage transistor amplifier. When a weak AC signal is applied to the base of the transistor, a small base current starting to flow in the circuit. So you can see here, if you know the basic of the transistor, the base is here. The input signal is applied from this terminal to the base. As you know, the common emitter configuration that has a current amplification factor called as a beta. Beta's value is always depending upon which transistor we are using, which application we are using, and which type of transistor we are using. It has a values that is starting from 20, ends on 400 or 500. So the value of the beta is very, very large. You know what is the beta? Beta is the current amplification factor, and it is given by the collector current IC, the correct current over here IC, divided by the base current IB. So this will be the amplification factor. Means a base current is very, very small, the beta is having very, very large, means the collector current is very, very large. So by just seeing the amplification factor, you can see that the input is multiplied by 200 or 400 times so that the output is there. So due to the transistor's action, a much larger beta, so beta times the base current. So I have said that the beta is almost from 20 towards the 400. So that much times the base current, the AC current, or we can say the collector current, that will flow through the load resistance RC in the output circuit. So here the current that is flowing through them, that will be the alternating current AC, because the signal that is alternating current, the audio signal. So the load resistance value is very, very large. A large voltage drop will be across it. And finally, we have a very large value of the collector current. It leads to larger value of the audio. So thus, a weak signal is applied in the base circuit that appears in amplified form, beta times the base current, in collector circuit. So in this way, the transistor will be act as an amplifier. So what is the role of the other components available in there? Because your syllabus contains only a name, audio amplifier. So we'll stick to audio amplifier only. So the various circuit elements and their functions are described as: we have a biasing socket. So where is the biasing socket? R1 and R2. It is connected from plus VCC to the middle of them. It is a voltage divider network. Middle of it connected to the base, and finally is connected to ground. So this will form a biasing circuit, and RE is there. So RE will provide a stabilization thing. So the resistance R1, R2 and RE will provide biasing and the stabilization. So the biasing circuit must establish a proper operating point. May you familiar with the operating point where it will give us the output signal as a full cycle of the input signal. If the operating point is not good, what will happen? We'll get the cut, or the negative part of the half cycle of the signal may get cut off. So to get a faithful amplification, means whatsoever the input, it should be amplified and available at the output. We need to have R1 and R2 in such a way that it should having a proper operating point. So this is the role of the biasing circuit. The input capacitor Cin, the electrolytic capacitor, is connected at the Cin part, the value of 10 microfarad, and is used to couple the signal to the base of the transistor. So it will couple the input signal to the base of the transistor. You know, the capacitor is always passing the AC signal. It will block whatsoever the DC signal is there. So if the hum or thing is there, like it is a constant, it will get neglected by this capacitor Cin. So the signal source resistance will come across R2. So this particular signal has some sort of source resistance. It will come across R2. So it will form like the parallel combination R2 and the input signal source that will change some kind of biasing thing. So this capacitor will allow the AC signal to flow, but isolate the signal source from R2. So there will be no current that is flowing, the DC current that is flowing through this Cin. So that's why it will isolate the signal source from R2. So we'll have only AC signal that is flowing towards the base. So this is the important role of the input capacitor Cin. We have a bypass capacitor CE. What we can say is that when the transistor is in working condition, what will happen? The collector will start flowing through the RC. It will flow towards the emitter, towards the ground. Okay. So an emitter bypass capacitor is there, which is having a value of 100 microfarad. It is used in parallel with RE to provide low reactance path to the amplified AC signal. So means the AC signal will follow the CE part. It will not going to follow the RE part. So the stabilization will be there. The low reactance path is nothing but it will flow through CE only. So if this capacitor is not connected, what will happen? The output circuit. Then the amplified AC signal will flow through RE and cause a voltage drop across it. So it is AC signal. So there will be some kind of voltage drop across RE. So it should have, as you know, the current always takes the easiest path. So it takes the easiest path as it is alternating current. The easiest path is through capacitor CE. So it will not going to reduce the output voltage. So this is the use of the emitter bypass capacitor. The next part, that is a coupling capacitor. The coupling capacitor of the value 10 microfarad is used to couple one stage of the amplification to the next stage. So we can have many stages of it, the audio amplifier. So if it is not used, what will happen? The biasing condition of the next stage will be drastically changed. As you can see, the Cin is over here. Cin is there. That's why the source resistance is not comes across this R2 resistance and the operating point remains stable. So that's why the CC will play the part of Cin in next circuit. So if it is not used, what will happen? The source resistance path, source resistance will come into the picture and it will like change, drastically change the operating point. So what will happen? So due to the shunting effect of RC, the drastically change in the operating point will leads to the audio amplifier will have no faithful amplification. So this is because RC will come in parallel with the resistance R1 of the biasing circuit of the next stage. So this RC will come parallel with the R2 of the next stage. So that's why what will happen? That will alter the biasing condition of the next stage. That's why we should need CC over there. So therefore the coupling capacitor is used to isolate the DC from one stage from the next stage and allow the AC signal to follow to the next stage. So this is it from the audio amplifier. If you have any queries regarding it, you can ask me. I will stop the recording now.